Hi, I'm Melanie, a pediatric occupational therapist with Alberta Health Services. In the senses video, you learned about the eight senses and how your child's brain takes in sensations. In this video, you'll learn why different people can have different reactions to the same sensation, how a person takes in, understands, and responds to sensation is called sensory processing. The brain needs input from the senses to function. Sensation is fuel for the brain. Everybody processes sensory information. Adults, children, babies, everyone. How your child processes sensory information is unique to them. Sensory processing has three stages. First, your child's body takes in information or sensory input. This comes from the eight senses. Next, their brain processes the information. It identifies it, organizes it, and gives it meaning. Do they like it? Does it make them feel safe? Not like it? Not safe. Then, their brain decides what to do. This may be a physical action, an emotional reaction, or both. The action or reaction can be seen as a response to sensation. This response then leads to a new sensation. Then this change in sensation gets processed. Sensory processing is a constant loop and happens very fast in the brain. Different people will have different responses to the same sensation. How your child processes sensation is what makes them respond differently. Everyone processes sensation differently because the brain uses experiences and history to understand sensations. Imagine your child experiences the following: something warm and furry touches their leg. They feel pressure against their leg. There's the sound of something breathing or panting, and there's the smell of an animal. This is your child's body taking in sensory input. Now it's time to process it. Warm and furry, pressure, panting, dog smell. It's a dog. The response your child has to this sensation is going to depend on their experience. If they're at home, have a pet dog, and feel these sensations, they'll process the input and likely have a positive response. They might lean down and pet the dog. If your child doesn't like dogs, their response to the same sensations might be to move away. If your child isn't home or is afraid of dogs, their response to the same sensations might be to feel scared or run away. The sensation is the same in all these scenarios. The difference is how your child's brain processes it. How the brain processes sensation is unique to each person. How your child processes sensation helps shape their sensory preferences. Watch the next videos in this series to learn more about reactions to sensations.
Find information, support, and services for you and your child by clicking on the link in the description.